hello all. Now I am going to discuss about microwave inventions. Already we have discussed what is microwave components. Microwave components, for example, the microwave junctions and ferrite devices and directional couplers. So microwave junctions, in the microwave junctions we are going to discuss about the junction which is having the shape like an English alphabet letter capital T. So we are going to discuss about microwave T junctions. A T junction is an interconnection of three waveguides which is in the shape of capital T. And there are three types of microwave T junctions we are going to discuss. First one, H plane T, E plane T, next EH plane T, combination of both E and H, and it is also called as hybrid T or magic T. So first I am going to discuss about a H plane T. So in H plane T, so this is a English alphabet like it is existing, that is capital T, and this is the actual waveguide, okay, and for this waveguide another waveguide is attached such that we are having three ports, port 1, port 2, port 3. And how the H plane T is formed? So here a H plane T junction is formed by cutting a rectangular slot along the width of the main waveguide. And attaching another waveguide, that is the side arm called H arm. Okay, so how this T H plane T junction is formed? So we have to consider a rectangular waveguide. So here we have the H plane T junction is formed by cutting a rectangular slot along the width. So this is actually the width, okay, which is having the width B. By cutting the rectangular slot along the direction of width, okay, like this, and attaching another arm which is acting as a side arm or H arm. So this is actually the main waveguide. For the main waveguide, we are cutting the main waveguide along the width direction and attaching another waveguide such that we are having a T junction. And why then I name H plane T? Okay, why the name H plane T means, here all three arms of H plane T lie in the plane of magnetic field, and the magnetic field divides itself into the arms. Therefore this is called a current junction. So magnetic field and electric field, both are we know. So electric field means its discussion fully involves in the terms of voltages. The magnetic field means its discussion will be involved in the terms of currents. Okay, so H plane, because the magnetic field is dividing into the arms, that's why the name called H plane. And this is called a current junction. If the voltage is dividing, then it is E plane T, then it is known as a voltage junction. Okay, so here H plane T is so called because all three arms of H plane T lie in the plane of magnetic field. The magnetic field divides itself into the arms. Therefore, this is called a current junction. Okay, so here the properties of H-plane T can be completely defined by its scattering matrix. The order of the scattering matrix is 3 by 3 because we are having 3 ports, and always the scattering matrix is a square matrix. Already we have discussed the properties of scattering matrix. So here the H-plane T is having 3 ports, that's why the order of the scattering matrix will be 3 by 3. Since there are 3 possible inputs and 3 possible outputs. So here the scattering matrix can be written like this: 1 1, 1 2, 1 3, 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 3 1, 3 2, 3 3. Now we determine the S parameters by applying the properties of scattering matrix S. So what is the first property of scattering matrix? And here in the diagram we have also written it as a plane of symmetry. It is having plane of symmetry. Plane of symmetry is nothing but we are exactly cutting the main rectangular waveguide along the width direction, okay, such that the left part is always equal to the right part. The plane of symmetry, port 1, port 2 are in a plane of symmetry. Okay, so now I am applying that property, first one, that is a plane of property. So plane of symmetry, because of plane of symmetry of the junction, scattering quotients S13 and S23 must be equal. S13 and S23 must be equal. 1 3, 2 3, right? These are having the plane of symmetry such that S13 is equal to S23. So S13 is equal to S23. Second one, what is the first property of a scattering matrix? That is symmetry property. This is the first property, that is square matrix, because number of inputs and is equal to number of outputs. Sorry, possible number of inputs and possible number of output, that is number of ports. First property is, that is square matrix property. Second property is a plane of symmetry, that is existing from the H-plane T junction. Next, third property is a symmetry property. Symmetry property is a second property of the properties we have discussed in the S matrix. So from the symmetry property, symmetric, this one is symmetry, this is symmetric. Symmetric property, so from the symmetric property, that is Sij is equal to Sji, S12 may be equal to S21, S13 equal to S31, next S32 is equal to S23, like that. But we know that S13 is always equal to the S23 according to the symmetry property. So S13 is equal to S31 is equal to S13 is equal to S31 is equal to S23 is equal to S32, like that. Okay, next, what is the third one? Since port is perfectly matched, I am assuming that the port 3, that is H arm, which is attached to the rectangular waveguide, which is perfectly matched to the junction. So perfectly matched means there is no reflecting power from this port into the junction. Okay, since the port is perfectly matched to the junction, I am assuming that H33 is equal to 0. Okay, so I am substituting all these properties into the matrix. Okay, so actually what is the matrix I am having? 1 1 1 2 1 3 2 1 2 2 2 3 3 1 3 2 3 3. Okay, this is a matrix, right? And now I am substituting all these values. S11, S12, S13. And what is S21? S21 can be written as S12, S22. And S23 can be written as S23. Can be written as S13. Okay, next. S31 can be written as S13. S32 can be written as S13. And S33. What is S33? It is 0. Okay. So here we have 4 unknowns. 1, 2, 3, and 4. These 3 and this one. So we have 4 unknowns. Next, what is unitary property? From the unitary property, that is S into S star is equals to I, 1 1 1 2 1 3, 1 2 2 2 1 3, 1 3 1 3 0, and S star, complex conjugate, 1 1 star, 1 2 star, 1 3 star, 1 2 star, 2 2 star, 1 3 star, 1 3 star, 1 3 star, 0 equal to unitary matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, so this is unitary property. So we have to do the multiplication now, and we have to make it equal to the these diagonal elements. Okay, first this one and this one, row 1 column 1. Next, row 2 column 2, row 3 column 3. Okay, multiplying R1 C1 is equal to S11 S11 star, S12 S12 star, S13 S13 star is equal to 1. So here S11 whole square, S12 whole square, S13 whole square equal to 1. Similarly, we have to go for R2 C2. S12 whole square, S22 whole square, S13 whole square. Next, R3 C3, S13 whole square, S13 whole square equal to 1. Okay, see, R1 C1, S11 S11, S12 S12, S13 S13, R2 C2. S12 S12, S22 S22, S13 S13, R3 C3, only 2 elements, S13 and S13. S13 whole square plus S13 whole square is equal to 1. Okay? And consider this as equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. And we have to go for similarly R3 C1. So R3C1, S13 into S11 star, S13 into S12 star equal to 0. R3C1, 13 into 11 star, 13 into 12 star equal to corresponding element is 0. Consider this as equation 4. Now, from equation 3, from equation 3, 2 into S13 whole square equal to 1. So S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Next, by comparing equation 1 and 2, S11, S12, S13. So here S11 whole square is equal to S22 whole square. Left hand side all terms is equal to right hand side all terms except this S11 and S22. So here modulus of S11 whole square is equal to modulus of S22 whole square. So S11 is equal to S22. This is the one resolution we got, and this is the one resolution we got. S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. Next, from equation 4. From equation 4, I am taking out common S13 into S11 star plus S12 star is equal to 0. Okay, so as S13 is not equal to 0, because already we got the value of S13 as 1 by root 2. Since S13 is not equal to 0, this term, this addition of S11 star and S12 star should be equal to 0, such that we will get the resolution that S11 star is equal to minus of S12 star, or S11 is equal to minus of S12. So this is the one more resolution we got. Next, using equation 1. Equation 1 and substitute all these values. What is S11? What is S13? And what is S12? Okay. So consider equation 1. S11 whole square. And what is S12? S12 is equal to S11 only. But we are having square. So minus term will be vanish. S11 whole square plus what is S13. S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 whole square is equal to 1. So here 2 into S11 whole square is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. So S11 whole square is equal to 1 by 4. So S11 is equal to 1 by 2. So if I got S11 is equal to 1 by 2, what is S12? S12 is equal to minus 1 by 2. And S11 is always equal to the S22. And we got S13. So now we got all unknowns. Now the scattering matrix. What is the scattering matrix we are having? S is equals to S11, S12, S13, S12, S22, S13, 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 0. Okay. So what is S11? S11 value 1 by 2. This is minus 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2. This is 1 by root 2, this is 1 by root 2, this is 0. This is scattering matrix. Okay. And we know that column matrix of output is equal to scattering matrix into column matrix of input. So how many ports we are having? Total 3 ports. 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 1 by root 2. Thank you. A1, A2, A3. B1 is equal to, B1 can be written as 1 by 2 A1 minus 1 by 2 A2 plus 1 by root 2 A3. What is B2? Minus 1 by 2 A1 plus 1 by 2 A2 plus 1 by root 2 A3. Next, what is B3? 1 by root 2 A1 plus 1 by root 2 A2 plus 0. Okay, now I am writing the case 1. What is case 1? If the input is given at port 3. Okay, input is given at, input is at port 3. And no inputs at port 1 and 2. That is, A3 is not equal to 0, but A1 is equal to, A2 is equal to 0. Then what is the outputs? B1, B2, B3 values. So if I substitute A1 0, A2 0, so B1 is equal to 0, 0, A3 by root 2. What is B2? A1 0, A2 0, it is A3 by root 2. Next, A1 0, A2 0. So B3 equal to 0. So what is happening now? So if I am applying the input at the port 3, that is H arm, and the output is equally divided into the port 1 and port 2, and there is no output or the reflection, there is no reflection in the port 3, because I already assumed that the port 3 or H arm or side arm is perfectly matched. If it is a perfectly matched, there is no reflection in the in that particular arm. So if I am applying the input at the port 3, port 1, port 2, the powers are equally divided. Okay, so it can be represented as like this. Let P3 be the power input at port 3, and this power equally divides between the port 1 and port 2, that is P1 and P2. Okay, so I am writing P3 is equal to P1 plus P2, but I can write it as 2P1 or 2P2, because P1 power is equal to P2 power. Okay, so the amount of power, the amount of power coming out of port 1 and 2 due to input at port 3, input at port 3 is equal to 10 log to the base 10 output by input, or 10 log to the base 10, what is input, P3 is equal to 2P1, so it is 10 log 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 means 2 power minus 1. Okay, that minus can be written here. 2. Log 2 to the base 10. It is having the value. If I multiply this one, I'll get 3 dB. Okay, hence the power coming out of port 1 and port 2 is 3 dB down with respect to the input power at port 3. Hence H plane T is called 3 dB splitter. H plane T is called 3 dB splitter. Okay, and one more case we have to discuss, case 2. That is, A1 is equal to, A2 is equal to A, and A3 equal to 0. That is, no input power at a port 3. I am not applying any input to the port 3, but I am applying the equal powers at port 1 and port 2. Then B1 is equal to A by 2 minus A by 2 plus A3 by root 2. This one will get cancelled and A3 is 0. So B1 0. Similarly, B2 I'll get 0 and B3 I'll get A by root 2 plus A by root 2. So what is happening here? What is the conclusion we can make here? So here B2 is equal to 0 and B3 is A by root 2 and A by root 2. What it means? If I am not applying any power at the port 3 and I am applying the power at port 1 and port 2 equally. Okay, so port 1 and port 2, I am applying the inputs equally with the equal amount of powers. Then the output from the port 3 is addition of these two powers. Okay, and there is no reflections in the port 1 and port 2. That is, port 1 and port 2 are perfectly matched. So this is about the H-plane T. Thank you.